Now, if you've made it this far, congratulations. I told you in the beginning, this first stuff is absolutely, oh, if I say boring, I think many people are going to be angry at me because certainly they, you know, some of it is interesting, but you've got to wade through these things and you've got to wonder to yourself, where is all this going? Is it going to mean something? There's this abstract algebra, so when do I get to groups? But this is all the foundation that we are building. I mean, this is one way to study abstract algebra. You just build this foundation until you get to groups, rings, fields, all of these things, or you can just jump in there and then you have to attach all these things onto it so that you can understand it properly. So in this series, we're just building it from the ground up, which means in the beginning, it's awkward. You don't know how to do it. You don't know why you're learning these things. It's just these, you know, definitions and abstract things that you've got to get together. What I do want to say is congratulations, you've made it till here, because we're going to actually get to one of the more interesting things, although it is still part of the building blocks. And this thing that we are going to get to is called operations. And I don't just say operations, and that means surgery, and surgery is what I do for a living. It means operations are actually quite interesting. And you actually know operations before. The addition of two numbers, the multiplication of two numbers, those are operations. And operations are nothing other than this product set onto itself. So if I have a set S and I take its product set with S, with itself, what I'm doing is I'm mapping S into S. So, you know, give me one element of S, I do some operation with another element of S, and what I'm ended up with is another element that is just inside of S. I mean, if you looked at the set of real numbers and I told you, oh, well, let the operation be addition, and I'm going to say, well, 2 plus 3, and that equals 5. Well, 2 is an element of R, if the real number was my S here. 3 is an element of that. I do this operation to them, and I get 5, and 5 is also an element there. So we say that these operations are, or these sets are closed under a certain operation. So remember that term, you're going to come across it many times. It is closed under the operation, that means that if I do that operation on a set, that I get to another element that's also inside of that set, so I'm just mapping a set to itself, a product set. See how we build all of those things up? They mean something to us now. It means we have a better understanding perhaps of what is going on here. Now, the specific operations that we are really going to deal with, a more proper term for that is going to be a binary operation. Okay, binary in as much as we're going to take this operator on two elements. So what we are going to then have basically is this mapping of two of a pair of those elements. So I could have said that this mapping here under addition is going to give me this operation 2 plus 3, and that is going to map to another element in that set, which is 5. Now you'll come across this idea that we move away from plus and multiplication and we build this generic operation, and we have signs for that. Either it's a little circle or it's a square block. You'll see many of these as stars sometimes. It just means that this is a binary operation on that set, so that we can get away from that arithmetic and everything that you've learned before, functions. Remember, let me talk about that. I mean, we had a function f of x equals 3x. Other words, y equals 3 of x. All I'm doing is I'm building these product sets. Because you give me 1 and 3, and I say, well, that maps to 3. So this is an R, this is an R, this is an R, but I want to move away from this being a function. I want to move to something more generic, which is a mapping, because that allows us to map all sorts of brilliant things. I mean, a mapping of is divisible by, for instance, or just arbitrary mappings between elements of a set. It is so much richer than just sticking to functions. But you were told what functions are. You work with functions, but just see that as part of something a much bigger and a much more exciting world. So let's just look at a few operations. So one that I've listed here is the addition, let's take the even natural numbers under addition. Even natural numbers. I'm just going to write that. They are closed under addition. Why? Because I can take any two elements in that set. So 2 plus 4, that's going to give me 6. And 6 is also in that set. If I look at the odd natural numbers under addition, that is certainly not closed under addition. 1 plus 3 gives me 4. 1 is in that set. 3 is in that set, but 4 definitely is definitely not in that set. Let's have a look at a set A. And my set A is just going to be the set 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I say, is that set closed under addition? Think about it. It is not closed under addition because I can say 2 plus 3 equals 5, and that is not an element of A. Is it closed under multiplication? No, it's not closed under multiplication because 2 times 3 equals 6, and that is definitely not an element of A. So you see where these binary operations are going. I think in the next example, I'm going to show you quite an abstract set and the operations on that set, and you'll get an even deeper understanding of this very intuitive way of looking at it. So operations, first bit of excitement as far as I'm concerned in abstract algebra.